going to present my work, my PhD about the reproducibility of scientific workflow in the cloud using container virtualization. So in this world, we have developed a new approach for repeatability and reproducibility of scientific workflow, which combines Tosca specification and Docker container to support on-demand and automatic deployment of the workflow, combine logical and physical presentation for the workflow and its components, tracking changes of the workflow and different components, and automatic image capturing and sharing for both the workflow and all the tasks. I will start with a brief background and then present some challenges for workflow reproducibility. Then I'll present our solution for logical and physical presentation of the workflow and overview of our framework for the reproducibility and some conclusion. So, commonly scientific workflows included set of tasks. Each task could be developed in different technology using depending on different tools and different packages to be executed, and also may each task need a different execution environment to be executed. By time, this workflow has been discovered that it couldn't be rerun or even if it be re-executed or rerun will not produce the same results. So different, some of the studies conducted different experiments to investigate the challenges for workflow reproducibility, which we can be summarized in the following. Firstly, insufficient or not enough description about the workflow, all the components, including its task and the relationships, different relationships between these tasks. Or insufficient description of the execution environment, or this execution environment is disappeared or has been changed. Absence and change of all the dependencies or some of the dependencies software that needed by the workflow to execute its task. The other reason is missing the input data. Sometimes even if the workflow exists, missing the sample or input data is helpful to produce or reproduce the same result. Other reasons could be the facilities to automatic use or reuse, re-execute the workflow. Different tools, approaches have been developed to address these problems. Most of these tools can be categorized in two directions. First direction, some of the tools, they are trying to tackle these problems by what is known as logical preservation, which means trying to describe the workflow and the component on different level of details. The other direction is packaging the workflow, including all its components, using some packaging tools like VM, like compressing, reprozip, different tools. Both of these directions have some advantages, some disadvantages. So we tried in this work to combine these two directions of reservation in one approach. So for logical preservation, we adopt Tosca specification, which is topology and orchestration of cloud application. In this specification, we could describe the workflow, its components in a portable and reusable entities. We could describe all the relationships, either the vertical relationships, which means task and all the software stack that it needs to execute the task, including the execution environment, including all the dependencies and the task itself. And we can, and also to describe all the horizontal relationship between tasks to transform data between these tasks. So the TOSCA description starts by defining usable entities of each component. Then out of this component, we created full description of the workflow. This description have been used also to deploy, automatic deploy this workflow with the some of the scripts attached to the description. These scripts could be Python scripts or could be Bash scripts. For physical preservation, we have used Docker container as the execution environment for each task. So, started by a base image, which is compatible or needed by the task. We created a container and then installed on demand all dependencies or packages needed to execute the task, then download the task. After that, automatically using the scripts attached with the workflow, task description of the workflow, we have created task image that is compatible with the task version. Each task in our workflow is version using system version control. And then after creating the task image, the data being fetched to the container and the task being created. By the end of executing each task, the container being destroyed. So if it's for the next time, if the same task will be used in the same workflow or in the other workflow, instead of using the base image and downloading everything, we will use the task image that will be created automatically, and this task also will be chosen automatically depending on the task version. And then we optimize some of the time for the deployment of the task and immediately fetching the data and executing the task again, the container will be destroyed. So, using Docker, we preserve, we package the task, including everything, and this deployment and this image creation has been achieved using TOSCA specification. So the overall overview of our observability framework is as follows. For each task, we create a repository, and for each workflow as well. So the task being created for a workflow can be reused for other workflow, not just for the specific workflow. So the reusability is for the task and for the workflow. All the basic types also defined for a workflow can be reused with the other workflows. And the lifecycle scripts that we use to deploy and to manage the deployment of the workflow can be used with all the other workflows. And we created also image repository. We created three levels of repository. Local level, which can be used locally in one community, and the other repository can be used publicly, and very specific or private repository which can be used just inside one machine. These artifacts will be used to deploy the workflow and to do automatic share and to automatic create the workflow. The deployment of the TOSCA is achieved using Cloudify, which is TOSCA based runtime environment. Our solution or our approach have been tested to deploy and reproduce the workflow and tasks on different environments, including local VM, Amazon Azure, and Google Cloud. So, during the deployment process and after creation of the image, this image automatically is being shared to public or to the private repository in parallel with the deployment, but it's not affect the time of the deployment time. So the process of creating this image and publishing this image is part from, it's not part of from the deployment time. The integration of Tosca and Docker container give us the flexibility not just deploying each task in different container. This is an example of a real workflow that has been designed initially in Design Central, which is a workflow management system developed in Newcastle University. So, the upper level, this is the task of the workflow, and then this layer is the dependencies, different tools that are used by the, each task, and then each task is deployed on different container, and this is the steps we use to deploy each task. The other option for deploying the workflow is deploy all the tasks in the same container. For example, if there is no conflict or these tasks can share the same dependencies, we can deploy everything in one container. In this case, the steps will be using just one container, installing everything, and then download the task, execute the task, and by the end, now we are creating an image for the whole workflow, not just for each task. So using this Tosca description, we either can deploy and create image for all the tasks, or we can create the image for just the workflow. Again, this image is reflecting a specific version of the workflow. So, these are the three levels of sharing the image. First, for each, inside each VM, this workflow will have the specific version and specific name that can be used all the workflow deploying in the same VM. The second one is a local cache that multi VM in the same cloud can use this local cache. For example, if we have some privacy reasons to keep the image not in public repository, we can just keep it in local cache. And the other one is the public cache. You can use Docker Hub or any other repository to share it to everyone. So, and finally, the efficiency of using Docker image in our approach is how each image is being selected when the deployment is done. If the workflow is being deployed for the first time, base image will be used to deploy each task. But if this this workflow be used by other user to reproduce the same result or just to re-execute, automatically each task image or workflow image will be selected depending on the task version or on the workflow version. If in the middle of the deployment there is another version or another copy of the same workflow being executed at the same time, these two copies can be shared the image created by any one of them. So if they start on different times, the image created by first workflow can be shared by the second one. So as a conclusion, full workflow sovereignty is a long-standing issue. So to solve this problem, we use Tosca description to logically preserve the workflow, to direct the automatic deployment of the workflow, and to create different type of Docker image. Docker image is used for packaging and supporting physical preservation of the workflow and the task. Workflow task image are used for change tracking on the task and in the workflow. Automatic naming, creation, sharing, and selecting of the image used to for the deployment facilitate reusability of the workflow and the task. And integration of all of these techniques addresses the majority of the issues related to workflow decay. Thank you very much.